Texas Big Star Live, and welcome to the world famous Horny Toad Bar and Grill in Cranfills Gap, Texas. Today we break into double digits because it's our 10th, count them 10, episode. Our 10th episode of Texas Big Star Live, and that's something to shout about. How's everybody doing out there? Let me hear you. All right. It's hopping, it's picking up here. And if I understand it right, there was someone at the bar that was going to buy everyone in this place a round to celebrate our 10th episode. Is that right, Matt?
Hey, come on.
No?
Did you see Tessa's face?
Some folks are not too happy with that call, Matt. Can we get a replay? All right. They woke up when I said free round, and then you just stayed. Of course, Kevin's like, well, you said free what? Okay, anyway. We, Texas Big Star, we want to say thank you to everyone who's played along with us, been involved. Owen and Sandy here at the Toad and on all of the Horny Toad crew, thank you so much. Especially our Texas Big Star sponsors. You know, our first Texas Big Star sponsor was Hot Ash Stove. And you've got to love the first person to jump on board. And so thank you, Ernie, and thank you, everyone at Hot Ash Stove. We're going to remind you also, go to hotashstove.com/TX and pick you up a Hot Ash Stove. You know, I asked you last week to go ahead and do that, so I hope you're hearing me. Get a Hot Ash Stove. I'm asking politely. I'm asking politely right now. Don't make... I can't be mean. Oh, I can't... I could. Does that get better ratings if you're mean to people on YouTube? Is that... Okay, all right, we'll try that next time. So once you've done that, once you've gone to Hot Ash Stove, listen, your phone's already up. You've got the computer on. You're settled in. You've got something to drink. You're in your comfort zone. You might as well go to Dublin Bottling Works, our other sponsor. Dublin Bottling Works. Those guys are just down the road in Dublin, Texas. And last week, Ray Lee, he won himself a Dublin six-pack, but he was so happy that he beat Clayton, which is not easy to do. He ran off and forgot to take the six-pack home with him. But he is back today. I heard him say just a moment ago he's here to play pool, obviously, but also to have himself some Dublin Bottling Works soda, and who wouldn't want that? It's awesome. So before we get started, we're going to go for our international chat today. Guess where we're going for next Sunday? Take a guess. International chat next week? We're supposed to be chatting with someone in Egypt. That should be interesting, right? Tune in next week. We're going to be chatting with Egypt during the show. Happens all the time. So today we've got the standard stuff. We got pool, obviously, Texas Big Star Live 8-Ball Showdown. What's in the box? Today's What's in the Box is very special. Mark Wallace is providing the item that will be in the box. He said he just came across it recently and thought it would be fun. Now, so Mark, since you're listening, make sure you get in the car and drive this direction soon. It may be a short show. What's in the box may come pretty quick. During Texas stuff, once again, we're going to talk Texas six-man football with Dr. Barry Fikes. He will provide an update on a special project that Texas Big Star has been working on. And then later today, our hope is to video chat with César Casasola from Guatemala, or at least that's the plan. And I think we've got a good connection with Guatemala right now, so we'll be chatting with him. So before we start the 8-Ball Showdown, let's say thank you to our Texas Big Star sponsors, Hot Ash Stove and Dublin Bottling Works. Dublin Bottling Works. You just saw Hot Ash Stove, but Dublin Bottling Works is also one of our sponsors here at Texas Big Star. And my treat for the show, obviously it's great for me to do the show because it's a lot of fun. It's wonderful people, wonderful place here at the Horny Toad in Cranfills Gap, Texas. But also, I know that I get to treat myself to a Dublin original, the original, case closed. If you like soda pop, soda, some folks call it Coca-Cola. So, Texas Big Star sponsor, Dublin Bottling Works. And don't forget, pick up a hot ash stove. Put it on your list for the coming weeks. Christmas is right around the corner. And don't forget to get your discount code at hotashstove.com/TX. It's going to save you $15. Order yourself some of the original. Anything they have there at Dublin Bottling Works is awesome. www.bottlingworks.com. www.dublinbottlingworks.com. And look for the buy button. Buy it. They'll send it to you. Hey, Matt. Let's get the tournament rolling and make sure everyone remembers that they're actually playing for some Dublin drinks. All righty, Texas Big Star Live 8-Ball Showdown starting right now, episode 10. There's Matthew looking at the draw.
So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Happens every week.
7 is Big Chris.
8 is you. You're 8.
Yeah.
Hey!
So what you doing here? Big Chris.
You know, I even
and I will play last. Make sure you have plenty of time to get there.
All right. Good idea.
Good idea? Yep. All right. Who won last week, Ray Lee? Who do you want to play?
I won last week.
Who do you want to play, Ray Lee?
I don't care.
Why don't you play Chris K?
Who do you want to play, Ray?
Oh, yeah.
Anybody.
That's what I'm about, huh?
Anybody.
Chris K. Oh. I hope you shoot like you shoot
last week. Like
these guys both won. They both won.
Come on.
Right off the bat.
I'll play Billy, Chris.
Me and Toddy.
Yeah, man.
You're going to pick the ladies against each other?
Yes.
This is a plot.
No, you got to do it.
I don't want to play it.
Okay. You'll play Penny.
Hey, I got mine. Penny.
Plays Penny.
Okay.
I'm going to play Penny.
Let's go, Penny.
I'm going to play you.
Dang.
I think right now.
I forgot about that.
Sure. Play fair. You can't talk.
Looks like Lil Chris is playing Penny. Oh, Penny's back. Side pocket Penny. Tessa's going to be playing Todd and Big Chris, and I missed the last name. But anyway.
Brian.
Yes.
Tessa and Todd are coming up with a set of rules.
Yeah.
Tessa and Todd are coming up with, you mean they're making up some rules or they're going to actually bring the official rules?
Just made up a rule.
Okay.
I don't know if Todd's going to abide by
it.
Yeah, she's saying that Todd can't talk during the match.
So but this would be, Matt, this is an addendum to an already standing article of Texas Big Star 8-Ball Showdown.
I think we can figure
I'm sorry, Tessa. I appreciate why you would want that, but you know, we'll have to make that rule before the
maybe
next
the whoever wins the week before gets to choose their opponent and gets to choose who gets duct tape the next week.
Exactly.
That would
so
give
Ray
some
Lee and Chris K are starting out, man. So those two guys have both won not too terribly long ago. So we're playing each other, knocking each other out right off the bat. All right, we're going to watch the break. Here we go.
Let's watch the break. Texas Big Star Live 8-Ball Showdown beginning momentarily. And in other news, it's been a lively week here this week. Yeah, that's in February, isn't it? Miriam said Puxatawny Phil. I have a hard enough time knowing what day it is.
I keep talking to you in the other mic so nobody else can hear me.
Yeah, I'd believe you. I would have said, that's right. It comes out before Thanksgiving every year.
That's right. No. What are you doing for Thanksgiving, Brian?
My family and I, we're going to be driving to Tennessee tomorrow.
Yeah, tell us what time you're leaving Texas to go to
Tennessee. Well, Katrina says she wants to leave at 4 a.m. Let me tell you something about want-tos in life. Want-tos are usually superseded by reality.
You just got real serious.
It's 4 a.m. It's like a paper route, man.
I did that.
I know you did.
I recall
when you guys ran a paper route.
That's right.
I was still amazed that someone could get up at 4 a.m.
I was good at it.
And not be going to fish. Rayleigh won the toss. He will crack them. And looks like Chris K has racked them. Rayleigh. I love it. Did you see Rayleigh spit in his right hand? He gets ready. That's old school. Oh, that's like being up to bat. That's awesome. Look at that. He is gazing right down the line. Here is the break. Skirts it a little bit. Wasn't what he was hoping for, but he did successfully sink the one. Oh, listen, there's so many ways to get things done. There he goes. He's got two down, and he is on a roll. While Rayleigh sets up that shot, I was just reminded a moment ago about Thanksgiving. You know, some local news here. It's deer season's been open for a week or so, just in time for Thanksgiving. And our locals here in Bosque County will soon send the deer away from the land of the living. East to west and north to south, we're Texas strong and we're Texas proud. It's sometimes strange and it's mostly true, the Bosque County news. Big Chris is supposedly on the way. Sometimes he's rather tardy, but let's face it, it's Big Chris we're talking about. No matter when he arrives, it'll be a party. East to west and north to south, we're Texas strong and we're Texas proud. It's sometimes strange and it's mostly true, the Bosque County news. Well, hopefully when Big Chris arrives momentarily, we'll get some more local flavor, a little more local, when I say emphasis on flavor, not local, just a little more. He's always got a story about what he's been into and what's going on, but speaking of what's going on, here's how I find out what's going on in Bosque County. Stick my head out my window and go, hey, what's going on? No, I go to Bosque Area Events. .com, and that's where we go. Bosque Area Events is a calendar. In case you didn't know, it's a calendar with compiles all the events that are going to be going on in Bosque County, so that you can plan things that way. So let's take a look at the calendar, see a few things that may be coming up. Today, obviously, is the 20th, and there's some things happening that happened this morning. And I've already happened. Ah, here we go. Thanksgiving lunch on the 24th. Right there, Thanksgiving Day. First United Methodist Church in Meridian. Ah, the Bosque Polar Express.
Hey,
Bosque
just,
Resort.
Brian.
Polar Express.
That dinner, that Thanksgiving lunch,
yes.
Actually. That Thanksgiving
uh-huh.
lunch is for anybody that's by themselves. Maybe they're shut-ins.
Ah.
They're actually making that lunch for them and taking it to them.
Wow.
So, yeah.
So
you
it's
can
delivered
either come to,
you.
To the church or they'll deliver it to you. Yeah.
Nice. Thank you, Miriam, for that update. That's great to know. The annual Homestead Heritage Fair, right there on the 25th, the Friday right after Thanksgiving, from 9 to 9. That's the one, that's right. Help. You can help to milk a cow, lend a hand at the old-fashioned timber frame barn raising. We discussed that last week. I'd love to see that. I think we'll be back. No, we'll be still in Tennessee. Clifton Farmers Market, still going on. Saturday, November 26th. It's going to be right there from 8 a.m. to 10 a.m. And the 55th annual German Heritage Sausage Supper. Wow. I bet you that's some good eating. I might be back for that. I might come back for that. Oh, goodness. So there's a little bit of what's coming down the pike for this next week. And also right there, you can see the Bosque Art Center, Arts of Christmas, and the Museum by Candlelight. That's a cool. That's really, really cool. So BosqueAreaEvents.com. If you go there, let me zoom out a little bit. Let me show you. Say you have an event that you want to let everybody know about. Get it on the calendar now. Don't wait till a week before the event, because there's so many things going on. Lots of interesting historical things that happen here on a regular basis. A lot of history here. You know, Lutefisk is coming up. Large Norwegian contingent. A lot of Norwegian history right here in the Gap and in Bosque area. This stuff's been on the calendar for a while. Go to Bosque Area Events, and then if you go to the top of the page, it says Add Event. Click on Add Event because you want to add your event to let everybody know that it's coming up. And then scroll down, you'll see a calendar of the month that you're in. And look right here. Look there. This guy's startup disk is almost full. That's going to happen next month. You post your event. And if you click on Post Your Event, look at this. Voila. It's a small form to fill out. Right? And that's it. And it lets folks know what's going on. It goes on the calendar, and bingo, Bosque Area Events has cured the illness of, hey, how do I let people know about my event? Because you want people to be there. Good thing. It's a real good thing. BosqueAreaEvents.com. Miriam, we need to let the folks know who makes BosqueAreaEvents.com possible. We have some wonderful sponsors, and Miriam is going to tell you who those folks are.
We have quite a few sponsors, actually. We've got a couple of really main premium sponsors. That's BCP Real Estate and Lone Star Ag Credit. Those are our premium sponsors. We also have other ones. Red Caboose Winery. They've got a location in Clifton. Their main winery is in Meridian. Here at the Honey Toad Bar and Grill, they are sponsors. Mustang Dental Care out of Meridian. The Crossroads Bar and Grill, also in Meridian. AirNet. Both Ace Hardware, Keith Ace Hardware, and Meridian Ace Hardware, and Richard D. Lundberg, and Patricia Coy and Associates. These are our sponsors for BosqueAreaEvents.com. And our premium, again, BCP Real Estate and Lone Star Ag Credit. We are always looking for other sponsors. If you're interested, just let us know.
That's right. Thank you, Miriam, and thank you to our sponsors that make Bosque Area Events possible. Visit them. Visit those folks. They're great people. Visit their businesses. Looks like we have had some change-up. Matt is at the table with the draw to show us what's going on. Ray Lee has defeated Chris K. Wow. Lil Chris, there's the coin toss. So it looks like Lil Chris is going to rack 'em, and Penny shall indeed crack 'em. So... moving right along. Folks, you are watching the 10th episode, a 1 and a 0. It's like living in the land of the digital. 1 and the 0 episode of Texas Big Star Live, right here from the historic, yea, verily, the most awesome Horny Toad Bar and Grill in Cranfills Gap, Texas. If you ever get a chance to, we would love for you to fall into the gap, because... not only is it just a cornucopia of interesting people, just the sights, the sounds, the smells.
So, Brian.
Of real, real life.
Brian.
Real life, right here.
Using that phrase, if they're no longer using that on a commercial on a regular basis, fall into the gap. Are we going to get in trouble for that?
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Okay.
I'm going to ignore you.
That's called plausible deniability. He has no idea what you're talking about.
Like, for instance, if I wrote a song with that phrase in it, I don't think you can copyright that.
You don't think they've trademarked it?
I'm going to say I don't know who they is.
Okay, there you go. Good call. Good call, Brian.
So you didn't hear what I said a while ago. Local news. What's the most recent news that happened right here at the Toad?
Well, oh, that's right. Miriam got an anniversary present.
She did. I found it outside on the ground.
Listen, you need to leave. The horny toads are almost extinct, so you need to leave them alone.
No, it wasn't that. It was another living creature. The puppy.
Oh, okay. That's much better than a bullfrog.
What kind of puppy is that? Do we have any idea, Jake?
We got any pictures?
Jake will see if he can get the picture to come on.
Okay. But, yeah.
This puppy was outside when I pulled up. And
Where'd it come from?
It was sitting, I don't know. It was sitting right out there. And then this lady right
here.
Come here.
It was here at the toad when you arrived.
There you are. See?
Hi.
Hey, tell us about the puppy.
It's precious.
Okay. She said that the puppy had been like underneath the toad. They heard it whimpering underneath a couple of days ago.
It must have been around for episode 9 then.
Yeah, that was your episode 9.
Come on, that's
put
funny.
It into, yeah, it's funny. So I pull up and it's literally right outside. And it's really, really cute. It was very sweet. It was very, very nice.
What color is it?
It's white. White and then cream and then like a kind of a gold patches around its eyes.
So it looks like a pop star.
Did you not see it? No, really. You came in after all that happened, right?
Yeah, I missed a lot.
I think Jake's getting a video up in just a little
Jake,
bit.
So. I mean, if Jake and Miriam weren't feeding me everything, I'd be a bust for this show.
So, yeah, it's a puppy that nobody was claiming. And there we go. There it is.
Yeah, look at your pig.
She's really, really, really sweet.
She's underfed.
Yeah, she was just like underneath. Oh, there she is.
What are you doing?
And
that's my new baby.
Miriam claimed her. Well, so here's the deal. If anybody's watching this and that's your puppy, you need to let us know real soon. Because otherwise, it's no longer your puppy.
That's
otherwise,
right.
It's going home with you guys.
Yeah, we ask multiple people. And she's really, really sweet. And
look, and she walks backwards. Yeah. That dog is trained already.
She's adorable.
Yeah. So Miriam's happy. So Jake wants kudos right now. He wants
kudos to Jake for all you do.
See, you can't hear what Jake's saying in our ears. Jake wants credit for transcoding
you.
That. He's transcoding
kudos
that video very quickly right off his phone in a format that he could roll into the show.
He's multitasking. A gazillion different ways.
He took a bow. He's very, very happy. See his thumb in the background there.
That's all.
But, I mean, that's news, kind of. I mean, it's really local, like a couple of feet away.
It's right behind this door.
All right, so Jake is telling us to shut up because he wants to see Pink.
Jake saying shush to all the world.
Jake wants to see this.
Lil Chris is... Well, he's holding his own. It's just like it's an even matchup right now. You just moved your monitor out of the way. You're interfering with billiards. Look at him go.
Hey. It's a lot of green. It's awesome. Oh, revenge for Wednesday night because he beat her last Wednesday night. I was in Dallas working on a TV commercial, so I didn't get to play Wednesday. I'm bitter about that.
Penny, not wasting any time. However, this next shot should be interesting. Where do you think she's going for this bank? That is the 8-ball. 8-ball looks like it's probably in the way.
Yeah, it's not going to work. I don't know.
She's not changing her mind, man. Oh, and we were correct. 8-ball was in the way. No. Well,
and that's what we call drama here at the
table. That's right. And that's why we're thankful these tables are not even close to being level.
Yeah. Uh-oh.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Lil Chris just opened up the door for maybe a possible whammy, but not leaving Penny any room in that corner pocket, looks like. She's trying to see if she can skirt just to the right of that five.
I don't think that's happening. That's not happening.
Nope, she's... I think she's sticking with plan A, man. Look at that.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh. Oh! You, she knows you, how that you table put a cat's kind of
whisker,
veers.
You couldn't put a cat's whisker between those two right there. That was threading the needle, and, of course, the eight ball is perfectly lined up where she left it.
Oh!
And
it,
in a stroke of luck, little Chris has really been rescued from the jaws of death, addressing the five ball again, and has a great
lot
shot.
Of green. A lot of green, Chris. A lot of green, Chris. A lot of green.
A lot of possibly uneven green.
Chris knows everybody's watching him. That's the part.
And little Chris.
Oh! Nice. Blood shot. Gotta go.
Nice. With a handshake, sending Penny on her way. This is a double elimination tournament right here, folks, at the Texas Big Star 8-Ball Showdown. And Matt's going to give us the latest. Ray Lee was victorious over Chris K just moments ago. And Lil Chris. Lil Chris, look for his new album on Epic Records called I'm Putting You in the Corner Pocket. Lil Chris. He's up there with Lil Wayne and Lil Shank. Well, yeah. Folks, we're still in our local segment of what we call local stuff. And, you know, one of the things we do for local stuff is a little thing that we call, hey, what's in the box? Hey, what's in the box? And today's guest is Mark Wallace, who's is a relation to Matt. It's Matt's father, Mark, who I know personally, have spoken with. It's just a wealth of knowledge all the time. Always has neat stuff around. So today's Hey, What's in the Box segment should be interesting because I never know what's in the box. I never know what it is. However, also... Let's try it there. Mark has so many neat things, and it could be anything. And I probably won't know what it is. So, Mark, come on over, sir. Welcome, welcome. I'm doing good. Here's your microphone. You can hold that and hold it kind of up there so we can hear you. This segment's called Hey, What's in the Box? And I was telling folks just a moment ago, I'm sure this is going to be a doozy.
Well, it's something that not just anybody will, you won't see them laying around very much anymore. But anyway, it's something that if you were in World War II,
oh,
you'd probably know what it is.
Okay.
But yeah, it's actually, of course, you can see that it's not as big as a bread box.
So it's not as big. I'm just going to go ahead and right, open it up here, okay, and we'll see what's inside there. Right. It's in a brown paper bag. This is, okay, I thought it was a grenade at first. I was going, he just brought a grenade from WW2. Let's call Tim Jeske quick. I don't know if you guys can see this, but it looks like something was, it did have some sort of pin in there, right there. This panel here is opaque, which leads me to believe that there might have been some sort of readout here. Might have been some sort of readout, or yeah, you guys can take a look at it there. See the wait! I didn't realize that. Now that I'm looking at it, okay, this is some sort of scope. This is some sort of viewing thing. See the sides, See, I thought it was a grenade laying in the box, which frightened me at first. So it mounted on something. I think that one little hole is a mounting point.
That's what it is. It mounts on to something.
Tank?
You're close.
Personnel carrier?
You're close.
Mounts onto a vehicle?
You're close. Yes, it's a vehicle.
What kind of vehicle? I don't know. A Jeep.
You've got it.
This mounts on a Jeep?
That's a blackout light.
A blackout light?
Blackout light. You know, when they have air raids.
Sure. Oh, yeah, blackout.
You know, they turn out all the lights.
Everything.
But now then your military still has to move around in the dark.
Sure.
And so these, you have two of these mounted on, coming out of your grill on your Jeep. Anyway, it doesn't really throw a lot of light, but people can see you coming, but you can't see them from the air.
Right.
And so, but this is it's a blackout light. It's a pair of them. You got them on each side right below the headlights. And so you turn off your headlights, you turn these on.
So this shot a beam of light then?
It's a vertical, it's a horizontal beam of light.
Right, right. It
doesn't diffuse up. You don't see it this way, it just goes this way.
You understand?
Yeah. But that's what that is. And that came off of a Jeep.
So yeah, the purpose of the light was for blackouts.
That's right.
And where did the name Jeep come from?
That's a good question. A lot of people don't know this. Now then, the Jeep, of course, you know, the manufacturers were Willis Motors.
I remember Willis.
And
yeah.
Ford. And anyway, in the Ford, they called it a GPW. But then whenever they would requisition it or they'd put it on the inventories, they'd call it a Jeep.
GP, just for short.
That's where it came from. General purpose.
General purpose.
Actually where the name Jeep actually came from.
So GPW stood for General Purpose Willis?
That's it, yeah. But Willis Motors, you know, Willis Motors and Ford are the two that made them during the war from 1941 to 1945.
So they shortened the name they just said Jeep, and then that's someone said, how do you spell that? And it put a J somewhere down the line. Someone just started using
that's
the
right.
J.
That's right.
How many Jeeps were made?
Well, I'll tell you what, there's about Ford, I think, 380,000. And Willis, 380,000. And Ford, 260,000 units.
Huh. Yeah. I wonder how many of those are still around.
There's still quite a few around. If you get online and start looking, you can still find some of these old World War II Jeeps. I have one myself. And my dad built it from parts right after the war. Right after the war, he started buying up salvage parts. He'd buy a motor this week. Next week, he might find a transmission or trunnions for the wheels, that kind of. So eventually, he built a Jeep.
You got a Willis?
I have a Willis Jeep, yes.
Huh.
And anyway, and so, but my dad did that all back in the early 50s. But there was a lot of war surplus still around.
Sure.
And anyway, and so if it was a Jeep part, he'd buy it. And so he actually built up from scratch about, I'd say probably half a dozen Jeeps over the years and sold them.
That's
but anyway,
correct.
But that's what this is. That came
a blackout light.
You bet you.
Mark, thank you so much. I'm always intrigued, and I learn something when I'm around Mark Wallace. Thank
well,
you so much, sir.
You bet you. Well, maybe we can find something else sometime.
Oh yeah, okay. You're always all welcome right. to
you bet.
Bring something and put it in the box. That was pretty cool. I like WW2 stuff. And the tournament is moving right along.
Tessa beat Todd, and she's happy. She's got a big smile on her. I got to go put her name on the board.
Tessa defeated Todd in the Texas Big Star 8-Ball Showdown. It is a double elimination. That doesn't mean Todd's out for the running, but he'll have a chance to redeem himself later on. Little Chris did defeat Penny. Tessa has upended Todd. Now Big Chris, who has arrived, which is nice, is playing our own Matt. Is that right? Is Matt playing? All right. Well, folks, Matt's going to be playing Big Chris. That means we're going to lumber along into our Texas stuff, the thing we call Texas stuff. Texas stuff, yeah. all the things in and around Texas. Today, we always start our Texas stuff, not just today, but every day, with a thing we call tracking the star. Star, star. Tracking the star. Star, star. We track the Texas star, stars that are, you know, celebrities that are born right here in Texas. And they're out and about doing stuff. We just kind of want to keep up with them. Let's tip our hat to, you know, we take care of our own here. So, Miriam, tell us what stars we are tracking today.
Well, today we are tracking only guys. It's all guys today.
Owen Wilson from
Owen
Dallas.
Wilson. He just celebrated a birthday on November 18th. I have no idea how old he is, but happy birthday, Owen.
Happy birthday, Owen. Awesome. I like Owen Wilson. Who is next? What's the next star?
Barry Corbin and Burton Gilliam, two of my favorite people. Recently, Waxahachie community raised money for the John Wayne Cancer Institution and had a bunch of celebrities there, including the Blazing Saddle star, Burton Gilliam, and Lonesome Dove star, Barry Corbin.
That's awesome. Both those guys are fantastic. Ha! Huh. So maybe you can do your own Western. But those two have never acted together, have they?
I don't know that they have. We'll have to find that out. I bet they've been
not.
In something together.
But if they did, know, it'd be awesome.
We'll get Jake to figure that one
yeah.
out.
Yeah. Who else are we tracking? This ought to be interesting.
Jamie Foxx. He recently supported his sister as she was part of an annual gala fashion show in Denver, Colorado that benefits the Global Down Syndrome Foundation, taking care of family and helping a good
Jamie
cause.
Jamie Foxx. That's great. That's real good. Who else?
Mr. Willie Nelson.
Willie Nelson.
Our royalty here in Texas. Tickets just recently went on sale for a January 2017 performance at the Lower Greenville venue in Dallas, the Granada Theater. And if you've never been there, it's a very cool venue. Willie Nelson family will play two very small intimate shows there at the Granada.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
So tickets are on sale for that?
January 2017, yeah.
In January, like.
Yeah.
New Year's Day, January?
No.
Somewhere?
I don't know exactly what day it is, but
better
I can find out for
fast.
You. Better make sure it's on the calendar.
Yeah. Get those fast, because they're going to go.
And that's
fast.
It for today.
That's it for our Tracking the Stars. Miriam, thank you so much.
So welcome.
Letting us know what's going on there. And another thing that we'd like to do here while Matt is... Can we peel over? Let's see what Big Chris and Matt are up to here. I want to see what progress has been made. None progress?
None progress.
Well, it does look like there's a lot of stuff on the table there. Matt's taking a shot right now. Looks like he's going for that six. Uh-huh. And he did sink one. There you go. That's, speaking of one, it lines him up for the one ball that he will probably handily put in the side pocket. Post haste. Well, folks, while Matt is clearing up the real estate, we're going to move along to our next section, which is a little bit interesting today. Miriam, I think you can appreciate part of this. I don't know if you know about this, but it's an interesting thing. We here at Texas Big Star Live, we keep up every week with the happenings, the stories that are found on one of our favorite Facebook pages, Texas Hill Country. Texas Hill Country Facebook page has really, really, really cool stuff. It's all about Texas, especially Texas Hill Country. And one of the stories on there, it's national, but it happened in the Houston area too, was that you've heard of K Jewelers?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
K Jewelers was caught switching out diamonds for fakes, apparently.
Are you kidding me?
But it was when apparently someone brought them one of their rings to be resized. And when they got the ring back, they had it for a while, took it to another jeweler, and the jeweler said, well, this, you know, this diamond's not real. And they had to go back to Kay and go, hey, somewhere the diamond became fake when I handed it to you. And apparently it happens when they send the diamond away from Kay to get sized and things.
Because
Kay is
usually
just a go-between kind of point. A lot of times they don't do the sizing and the things of that nature, or they do it out of house, as they say. And so, every kiss begins with K.
No.
Every fake begins with K.
Every fake.
I'm hoping I'm sure it's not a national trend. I'm saying that because in case K wants to be a sponsor of Texas Big Star Live.
Oh, they're definitely going to want to do that now.
Yeah. Think we ruined our chances?
Maybe.
Okay.
Just a little bit.
Moving right along. We're going to move along to, this is a good one. This guy made kiddie pool nachos. A man in Austin threw a party with a kiddie pool full of nachos.
Oh, my gosh.
Can you imagine? And apparently people didn't seem to have a problem with eating nachos from a kiddie pool.
Ew.
You know, I mean, I guess it's not too much different than eating off a plastic or a styrofoam plate. You think about it.
No.
No, it wasn't. I think it was a new pool. I don't even know. It could have been a used pool.
Okay, yeah. All right. Still.
Could have been a...
I mean, unless you're eating them immediately, I'm not thinking having a whole bunch of nachos sitting out in a kiddie pool is all
yeah,
that.
Yeah, I have four children, and every kiddie pool we've had has lasted about a month. You get sand, they get a hole in them. There's all sorts of weird, you know, insects start getting in there. But I'm sure, anyway, kiddie pool nachos, which brought to mind, I wonder what is the biggest nacho serving the Horny Toad has ever done?
I have no idea.
I'm going to talk to Owen and Sandy about that.
You should find that out. They rang the bell.
They rang the bell. Let's briefly skip over to the table and see what's
going
on.
Oh, Matt won.
Matt has defeated Big Chris. So, in the top bracket are Ray Lee and Lil Chris, Matt and Tessa. And in the consolation bracket is everyone else that was defeated by the aforementioned four folks.
Chris, Kay, and Penny.
Chris, Kay, and Penny. All right. Oh, so there's one more story that, and Miriam, also you will enjoy this. There was a story on the Texas Hill Country Facebook page.
This is better than the nachos, right?
About a guy that calls cattle using his trombone.
Nuh-uh.
It's a video. I think Jake's going to let us watch the video here. We're not going to watch all 4 minutes, but here he goes. We got volume on that too, don't we?
Wait, he's in a lawn chair.
He just sits the lawn chair in the middle of the field.
Oh my gosh, they're coming. Look on the horizon.
They do. They show up. Check that out.
Okay, that's awesome. No, what's he playing?
Yeah.
Are you kidding me? That's what he's playing?
Look at him. They're like at a, some of them are at a fast trot and headed his way.
Oh, that's adorable.
So he goes on to say, yeah, see, they're just staring at him. The article goes on to say that the reason they do that is because apparently it sounds like another cow in distress.
Oh.
The tone, the timbre, if you will, of the trombone, timbre.
One of the sweetest sounding brass instruments out there.
Yeah.
The trombone.
I wonder if... What would happen if you played a tuba?
I think that'd be awesome.
Be elephants. So that made me think of what other instruments could you use for different farm animals? Like goats. What would goats?
It'd have to be a brass instrument.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Anyway.
Those guys, they're just, if I understand what you're even looking at, they're just curious. It could be any noise that was weird, and they're going to come over and look.
Oh, you've spoken to a cow?
I've been around enough cat. I'm not a cowboy, but I've seen how cattle behave, and if they hear something weird, they're going to come over.
I think you should get Todd up and ask him.
So what?
All right, okay,
In the middle of the field.
I'm going to ask Tessa. Now, I'm going to ask Little Chris.
How would cows react to strawberry
fields? Out of this crew that's playing, who's the most cowboy? Who knows the most about cattle? It's your mama, isn't it? It is. I know it is. So, am I right, Tessa?
No, I didn't hear what you said. That's why I was laughing.
You have to involve her in the conversation.
You have to come over here now that we're talking to you. All right. You know, Tessa, I had to convince Tessa that this was not going to be the worst thing ever. And now she's quite comfortable in front of the camera. This is good. So here's the question. They're watching the video of the cattle.
Did you see what the video was?
No.
It's a guy who
plays trombone out in the
field. That sits a lawn chair down with a trombone and plays, and the cattle start coming toward that sound.
Oh yeah.
And I said, it's because no other reason than it's just a different sound. It doesn't scare them, but they're like, that's different. He's going to play. That's it. So he just plays, and they all come over the hill, see? And they just sit there and listen to him play. And I say it's just because they're not afraid of it, but it's weird, and so they're going to come check out what it is.
But the article says...
Yeah.
I'd be willing to bet.
Article says that it sound, the tone of the trombone sounds to them. And obviously, no one's actually communicated with a cow. I'm sure there's some Berkeley professor that says he has. However... No one's communicated with a cow, but the article says it probably sounds like a cow in distress a certain time.
Why would they go to a cow in distress?
They swarm a cow that's in distress.
Oh, okay. Well,
like, they come to the rescue.
That's called confidence.
There they go.
She sounds pretty confident.
No, I know. That's why she's over here, because I knew she knew more.
I'd be willing to bet this. Like, if you've heard people around here, obviously, honking their horn.
Uh-huh.
And they're calling their cows.
Sure.
So you can train cattle to anything with feed, any noise.
With feed.
So you've seen the sirens.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Right.
Some people play a certain song on the radio and their cows come to it, and they associate that with feed.
But tell me about one of these songs.
What?
Somebody, you just said, what's a song that you know somebody's done?
I don't know. I mean, yeah. I swear that.
Jake wants to know if it's gangster rap or not.
Bare
no,
metal.
But I mean.
Three Dog Night.
Yeah, that's my cow's like Bad Company.
Awesome. For real.
Or, wow. I don't know. I mean, just random stuff, but they do. And you've heard people like been in people's horse barns and they have music playing.
Yeah.
There's a lot of people here that haven't been in
horse
barns,
well,
but
animals
you have,
like
yeah.
it, and they say it's like soothing to animals, uh-huh. and they keep music playing and kind of desensitize them to different noises. It's like the baby effect. Like, if you want your kid to be able to sleep anywhere,
you make nice noises.
Yeah, if they're in a quiet, nice environment every time they go to sleep and you try to take them out and do something, they're miserable.
Tell them what we did, Matt.
I mean, people train cattle right. with feed. And associate that with music. It's also a soothing thing.
Miriam and I used to take our kids in the little car hopper bassinet thing mm-hmm. and sit them right in front of the speaker and listen to, like, Pink Floyd.
Yeah. I mean, it really...
And look what we got.
Yeah.
Yeah. So.
Which, here's the next question, and maybe not necessarily the more important question, but an interesting, thought-provoking question.
For him.
If... And I believe
that was
for most of you in the audience.
You're like, well, for...
If a trombone attracts cows, and let's say their theory is right, that the sound of the trombone is reminiscent of cows, what about Matt? His voice would attract what animal? Meaning you sound like what animal in distress?
That's not nice.
You could call...
Okay, me then.
Oh, well, okay, some people call their cows, and they make a certain noise.
No, I'm talking about that. Just for the voice.
I'm like, just wanting to know...
What animal would Matt attract?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's not nice.
What about our goats with Mark Wallace's voice?
Mark Wallace, who was just here, just says, goaty, 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 a certain way. Yeah, he's long gone, Jake.
And all his animals gone.
He just does that, and the goats come from everywhere.
That's it.
I mean, it's no big deal. I mean, it's just... I just wanted to know. I asked. I knew she probably, out of this crew, knew more about livestock than anybody.
But you
want to
know what animal...
That I would attract.
Or me, or who? I mean, who, your voice would attract what animal, you think? If you were...
I call cows. I mean, they know me.
I got to go. Here you go.
I don't know. What animal are you trying to attract?
Well, no, I'm just saying, based on...
I mean, that would be kind of dependent
true.
On what noise you're...
No, just you know, because they were saying the trombone, the tone of it sounds kind of like a cow in distress.
Right.
But let's say my voice would attract what animal? The trombone, they say, is kind of geared toward a cow. Sounding in distress. So a human's voice. I wonder what animal.
Yeah, I don't know.
I
mean, well, is it like, I don't know, the whole like Spanish serenade type music? Isn't that saying that their voice attracts the women of their, I don't know.
The culture?
Agriculture.
I see. Okay, so.
Well, okay, as an example, the bulls make different sounds than the cows.
Right, right. Okay.
So I guess it would kind of depend on. What?
Oh, way out
you need
there.
To talk to the cowboy. He found a hat. Somebody gave him the buckle, and now he's a legend in his own mind.
Uh-huh. Oh, wow.
And he was able to sort 9 cows off in 45 minutes. He's a cowboy.
That's, isn't that slow?
Yeah. It's okay. We're proud of you, Toddy. We really are.
Todd.
I think this is kind of working opposite for you, Todd. I thought the smack talking I was going to lose first and foremost. And then. Right. Yeah. I was desensitized. That's because I listen to it all the time.
Hear it all the time and you just become numb to it.
It's like the Charlie Brown Christmas thing. It goes womp, 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 womp.
Well.
Y'all know more about girls? Oh, okay. Well, that's not surprising.
Now see what we've done. We've got it yet. It's another bantering, another dramatic thing happening here.
That's what we do.
Folks, welcome to Texas Big Star Live. Live. Where we'll talk cows and we'll talk music. Apparently,
she's trying to be nice and hand it off. She's out of here. Thank you, Tessa. Apparently, I knew she would know.
Apparently, Longhorns dig bad company.
But I'm telling you, when she answered your question, you could see in her eyes that she has a level of confidence that you and I do not have.
Oh, I'm sure. Yeah, I mean, it's going to spur me on to communicate with cows. I'm going to try. I mean, I've got a Neil Diamond album.
Think that'll work?
I mean, who doesn't like Neil Diamond? You know what I'm saying?
They're quizzing each other over there. All
Where
right, so
it
I
find. Again. I can't begin to know it. Come on. You know that would work.
You ready to move on? You ready to move on?
To a different album?
Yeah, exactly. Oh, gosh.
We need to thank our sponsors again, Matt.
Right here at the really strong point of the show,
yeah. We
want to make sure they're associated with us.
We need to.
Hold on. Hey, Jake, do you have that one that insults all of Arkansas?
Got it queued up, baby.
It's not us, it's them. I think we should make them. They should have to explain themselves. What does Arkansas easy mean? Does that mean it's really easy? I think that's what they're trying to say. You have to drive through Arkansas to get back to Tennessee, don't you?
We do.
Y'all need to be careful talking about Arkansas.
Yeah.
My mom was in Arkansas.
Yeah, your mom is here. She's here.
She is.
She's here.
She'll come whip your butt.
Wow. She might do that.
Talk about TV. I like that. Glad to get that happening. No, she's too sweet for that.
She is very sweet.
All right.
Well, Matthew, I'm holding in my hand what I consider to be one of the finest soda pops, if you want to call it that.
See,
carbonated sweet beverage.
This one, did they change the design, or are they always going to have black cherry on it?
Well, it used to be called black cherry.
Yeah, that was before they called it the original.
Yeah, and I think the new one just pays homage to what it was labeled before.
That scares some people off, but it's that other drink that it tastes similar to, but better.
Yeah, there's such a cornucopia of awesomeness within this glass bottle, and this black cherry is one of the flavors.
It's interesting because, you know, in this particular case, I completely agree with you. That sounds like a, you know, sales pitch, but that's really good stuff.
It is. And Dublin Bottling Works, fine folks, fine product. Make it a fine fine day for you and me. And
DoublingBottlingWorks.com.
DoublingBottlingWorks.com.
You have to buy it by the case, though, right? I don't think
you. Why would you not buy it by the case?
Exactly. That's what you want to do.
Yeah.
So if somebody buys that, they need to buy that and tell them, hey, I saw that on Texas Big Star Live.
Please do. I might buy some and have it shipped to my brothers up in Tennessee.
I think it's funny how, I don't know. It doesn't sound cheesy when you do it, but I tell people to do that. It seems, I don't know.
Cheesy?
A little bit. Maybe it's just me. Probably.
It could be.
It is.
Maybe. It's overanalyzing stuff. Man.
That's my gift. You have talent.
That's your gift.
I have cheese. So, all right, so it is. Are we in Texas stuff, right? So where do you do Texas stuff? We're in Texas stuff. So what we were going to do.
We're still in there, but we're moving out of it.
So what we talked about doing is bringing Barry back and talk about what's going on, because that's a big deal. We want people to watch that series, and he's here.
Awesome.
I asked him, and he came. You ready to talk to him?
I'm ready to talk.
You can talk about how cold you got?
Yes.
Hey, Barry, come on. So, Dr. Barry Fikes is in the house. Here he is. Y'all have a good time.
Doctor, give me the news.
So are we doing the lean thing?
You know, it's by the time Sunday rolls around, I'm leaning on anything.
You have to lean
on
Sundays?
It just, you know, just kind of. Otherwise, I mean, I could stand up straighter.
No, I'll go ahead and lean. Let's lean.
I'm sure. Yeah, I like
weary leaning. Today.
Yeah.
So what are we talking about?
We're talking about Texas six-man football, and we're specifically talking about Richland Springs Cyotes.
Okay. I thought we were going to talk about existential theology and philosophy, but we're going to talk six-man football?
We could talk about existentialism.
No, we're not going to do that at
Which
all.
Brings me back to the Berkeley professor that has spoken with cows.
Well, there you go.
That's an old story. You've heard about that one?
No. Which one? What professor?
Years ago, I don't know, the guy came into his class and said, I'm here. He was an existentialist.
Yes.
Which,
you know what? We all are closet existentialists.
If you can experience it, then it must be real.
That's exactly
right.
He walked
into his class and said, I'm here to say that a bull moose can speak. I've heard them speak. I spoke with them.
Really?
And what he didn't tell people is that he had dropped a whole load of shrooms. He'd made himself a nice soup, mushroom soup.
Yes.
And went off into the woods and started conversing with.
I wonder what language that they conversed in.
And would they be attracted to a banjo?
Probably. Probably that or accordion.
Moose.
Yeah.
Tuba.
Tuba. There you go.
Probably so. That'll work.
Oh, the shout says replay.
What do we got?
Did Penny make an awesome shot?
All right, here we go.
Was that the eight ball? That was the eight ball shot. Here we go. Penny just made apparently a fantastic shot on Texas Big Star Live eight ball showdown. Oh, it's a bank. Kaboom, kaboom.
Oh, my.
Ah, yeah. Not for the faint of heart or the amateur right there.
I would never make that. It's not going to happen.
That is not an easy shot. Well, let's see. What happens now? Penny is in the, I believe she was in the consolation bracket. So if she has defeated Chris Kay. So Chris Kay's out of the running. All right. Little Chris and Ray Lee are up. So, Barry, we're talking, last week you were here talking about Texas six-man football.
Right.
And specifically, the Richland Springs Cyotes,
mm-hmm.
who are on a roll.
Yes.
They are headed in the direction of possibly winning that eighth state championship. That's a big deal.
That is a big deal, because that would tie them with three other teams, South Lake Carroll, Katy, and Salina, who have eight state championships.
Right.
Pretty big stuff. Now, you were at the game.
I was
this
at the
past
game
week
this
against
last
Milford.
Friday with
what did you
guys.
Think about that?
Well, that was first of all, it was kind of cold, very windy.
Right.
And Richland Springs started off kicking everything into the wind because of where they were on the field position. And it had some fantastic moments. This is the previous game from last week. Look at that. That was the first play of the game.
Yeah, kickoff return for touchdown.
Kickoff return for touchdown.
Yeah. We were up 16-0 before we had run one offensive play that night against Walnut Springs.
And there's the extra point. Yeah, that was the beginning of a fantastic game. And this last week, though, I must say, that was intense.
And it was highly entertaining, though.
It was very entertaining.
Animated.
It was animated.
Mm-hmm. A lot of blood flow, a lot of veins, thick, and all those kinds
there was,
of things.
You mentioned blood flow. At one point, I'm doing videography for the game, and I'm capturing as much as I can. And there was a bit of a ruckus, and there was a bit of a pause.
Uh-huh.
And I see a player scrambling, taking his jersey off. And I thought, did he just get ejected? What was going on? I went and asked you. It's because there was blood on his uniform.
Right.
He had to switch.
He had to change jerseys, yes.
To a same number, different number?
No, there's a young man on the team who suits out, but because of transfer rules, he can't play.
I see.
And so, you know, readily he volunteered his jersey, and so the jersey was transferred, and away we go. It's
away
all about team.
And there was drama. There was drama. The other team was pretty hyped up.
They were.
A lot of hype. A lot of talk.
I didn't engage in any of that.
Pre-game. It's just pre-game talk. I mean, I'm there pre-game. On the field, and I'm seeing words coming from one side of the field. And the Richland Springs guys just don't. They respond with silence and the scoreboard.
Yes. Now, they may say a few things, but it never looks like they do.
Then they're smart.
They're smart in that
so
way.
They're intelligent, too.
They're coached up is what they are. So we got a big game coming up this week. It'll be third round of the playoffs.
Yeah.
Playing the Calvert Trojans. And, you know, a lot of history between our two teams in the playoffs, yes. And I may be wrong on this, but I believe that we're 5-3 against them in playoff games.
Really?
And the last team to beat us, because we're on like a 25-26 game winning streak now, were the Calvert Trojans in this round of the playoffs in 2014.
My.
So it's going to be a big game. I mean, they're very good. They are very athletic. They're ranked number 2 in Division 2. We're ranked number 1.
Right.
So, you know, all kind of fireworks in Hyco, Texas, Saturday night, 7:30.
Hyco?
Or 7, maybe 7. Hyco, yes.
Right down the road from here.
Right down the road. You think you can make it back from Tennessee for that?
I wish I could. I don't know that we're coming back till Saturday, though.
Well, it is Saturday.
What time?
7 o'clock.
Yes.
You might be a little road weary. You may not
I might be. Well, if we leave at 4 a.m.
Uh-huh.
on Saturday, we can get here by then.
I don't want you to feel any pressure. But I don't want you to jinx us by not being there. But don't worry about it.
Yeah, right.
It's really not all that big a deal. I mean, we're just trying to make history, and we're trying to do this documentary. And so,
okay.
Don't feel any pressure, though.
No, please. I'm not feeling any right now at all.
I'm going to be talking with your wife and kids to make sure they get your butt in the car and get going at 4 o'clock.
A.M. paper route hours.
Yeah, that's it.
So this last game, though, I was reminded that, did you have a conversation with someone? It was a little interesting conversation that somebody was talking smack, maybe.
Well, yeah. In fact, one of their players, there were a lot of social media conversation between players, you know. And this young man was really animated and really fun. And, you know, he and I kind of carried on.
This is on social media.
Well, no, not on social media. We carried on our conversation during the game. I mean, he's so fun.
He's one of their players?
Oh, yeah. He was great, though.
Is he sitting on the bench with his phone?
Oh, no. It's on the field, you know, back and forth.
Gotcha. Okay. Yeah.
So, and I really, a 56-year-old man should not be engaging in this conversation. But I hugged him. He hugged me. He's a fine young man.
All right.
I'm not all that good, but he's a fine young man.
That's awesome. That was a great game, though. What was the final score?
Final 80? Score was 78-43.
43.
That's like the most points we've allowed all season. I don't know. I don't even know if we've allowed 43 points all season long.
I was about to say, I don't know that you have.
But, you know, they were very athletic and very good. And we weren't – I mean, I'm not trying to downplay their ability, but we didn't play our best game. We fundamentally broke down in a few areas, you know, tackling, blocking, the fundamental stuff. But they were very good, and it made for some very entertaining football. Didn't you think?
I did. Yeah, it was. I was riveted the entire game. I just
had a little bit of a carnival atmosphere to it.
It did, especially when both teams began to clear the benches.
Yeah.
That was fun.
I was admirable at that
point. And I was
point.
In the middle going, okay, I got teams coming from the left and the right.
Yeah, I was trying to push people away from doing that kind of
thing. Yeah. And it might have escalated, but there was one particular call that was one particular play in the end zone that sparked that.
Yes.
Which I believe, I'm pretty sure, and we will see it. I have that one on video.
I'll tell you? Okay.
Oh, yes.
All right. Is it coming up?
It'll be on the next. Tell folks where they can go to find what we're talking about here.
Go to Destined for Greatness, six-man history in the making.
Destined for Greatness.
Did I get it right finally?
Yeah.
Six-man football
history
in the making.
Yeah.
It's on YouTube. And several episode series of the quest.
TexasBigStar.com/football.
That's
where they can begin to find it right there, and it's Destined for Greatness.
If you just do Destined, there's a lot of Destined for Greatness stuff. You need to put in six-man football history in the making, or type in Richland Springs.
Yeah. If they go straight to that.
They'll go right there with
them. TexasBigStar.com/football will take them right there, and this next episode coming up, I'm sure they're going to be able to sense the what was in the air last Friday night. Yeah, it was pretty intense.
It was fun, though. I mean, and, it's just sometimes in the heat of competition, you get a little geeked up.
I tell you what, the crowd also, they were intense.
They were.
The Richlands, the Coyote fans, they outnumbered.
Yeah.
The opposing team had the large stands, but they still outnumbered.
Yeah. We travel pretty well. I mean, and the amazing thing is that we have a fan base that's more than just Richland Springs.
Right.
I mean, we have people that'll drive from Abilene, that follow them, other places around the state.
You got some fans right here in the Gap.
Well, that's true. In fact, probably need to give a shout-out to Todd and Peyton.
Yeah.
Sorensen.
Yeah.
They weren't able to be here today, but they sent me information over Facebook, and I appreciate that.
That's awesome.
Peyton had all four fingers, eight fingers up, talking about being on board, and so that's a good thing.
Wow. Well, it's that series on the TexasBigStar.com/football called Destined for Greatness. If you can, check it out, folks, and you'll see what we're talking about. Dr. Fikes is, in essence, hosting it.
Yes.
And just weaving a whole tapestry of the groundwork, if you will, of storyline behind why this is such a big deal. And it's a great series. It's an intense, but it just keeps you kind of going every week. You kind of feel like you're part of the family here.
Right.
Along for the ride.
Yeah. It really is. It's been a labor of love to be able to do it. And, all of my community and, all the coaches, all the players, all the fans. It's just, it's good to be able to say a good word about them.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, that's awesome. Barry, thank you.
You bet.
For keeping us up to date.
You bet.
And look
you.
Forward to seeing you again.
Be safe going to Nashville. Or Murfreesboro.
Murfreesboro, yeah.
There you go. All right. Take care.
See you. Dr. Barry Fikes. Back to pool. Ray Lee and Lil Chris are... Oh, looks like Lil Chris is doing, he's a 8-ball. We are down to the wire, and he has just successfully. He is. So he sends Ray Lee, to the consolation bracket, which means Ray Lee is not out, but he only can afford, no more losses, because if he is unvictorious in another game, he will be out. So the next consolation bracket is Todd and Ray Lee. My. It does look like Tessa and Matt are playing. Both Tessa and Matt undefeated. So this Should be an interesting game to see what transpires. Mm-mm-mm. Folks, you're watching Texas Big Star Live, our 10th episode, right here from the fabulous Horny Toad Bar and Grill in Cranfills Gap, Texas. We appreciate you viewing, watching, and you can always chat with us. Use a Facebook chat window and say hello or not. All right, we're on YouTube. We used to do the other one, right? Was it illegal? So, yes, on YouTube or wherever you can find us, just chat with us. Find your chat window. There's a break, Tessa, with a big break, and nothing drops. All that noise and nothing fell, leaving Matt the opportunity to. He has a choice of several different things. Wow. Got his pick of just about any flavor on the table. Mm-mm-mm. What will he choose? He's doing a combo. First shot, and he's going to combo. What's he going with? Oh, combo onto the one. Will it happen? Yeah. Oh, that smarts. Mm. Oh, I'm laughing, Jake. I can hear Jake in my left ear, and so can Matt. So Matt can hear everything we're saying about it. Well, that opens up the door for Tessa to make a little room, and now she is going for the solids and not wasting any time. Oh, but scratched on that number. Folks, we're moving slowly, lumbering toward our next segment of the show. And unless there's something I missed, that happens sometimes here at Texas Big Star Live. I miss things that might be obvious. Anybody think of any? Oh, I didn't. That was on the Texas Hill Country Facebook page. That's right, I forgot. We forgot one story here. This is interesting because you see it in movies. Apparently, recently, well, let's show them the picture, Jake. This is, can explain it. It is a video, yeah. Check out this video. From the movie Backdraft, yeah. But the first video you saw was the real deal. That was a fire hose going through the automobile's windows, which, let us remind you, it is illegal to block a fire hydrant with your vehicle. Because if you do, and there is a fire nearby, the fire department has every right, as they should, to smash out your windows to make it the easiest straight line to the fire, and that's what they did there, as you can see. You want to have less kinks in the hose, and it's all for safety reasons and to protect the general public, which is why our men and women who are fighting fires and saving lives, that's why we have them doing that. So, moving along in our World Stuff segment right now. It's hats around the world. That's right, I said hats. World stuff. World stuff. And hats around the world. Matt had a great idea, our producer Matt, to send hats around the world, cowboy hats around the world. That's right, we're gathering up all of your old cowboy hats. Maybe you have two or three that you just don't wear anymore. Maybe they're brand new, you just want to share them with us. You can send them to Texas Big Star Live, care of the Horny Toad Bar and Grill, 319 North 3rd, Cranfills Gap, Texas, 76637. And what we do is we're going to send those hats around the world. We have so many international connections and friends and folks that we know around the world. We're sending those hats to them. They're going to get those. Send us back some pictures to see how they look in the cowboy hats. And maybe they'll send us some of their hats. I'd like to have a Russian toque. Would be fun. Something like that. Yeah, we know some folks in Russia. That'd be great. So that's hats around the world. And, ooh, Matt is going for this shot. Pow. There he goes. Looks like this is pretty evenly matched right now. Solids and stripes. Matt's playing one catch-up. He's banking the 14, hoping to put it in the western side pocket. And he is, not successful. But that leaves that three ball wide open for Tessa to send home. Mm-mm-mm. There she goes. And it's in. Looks like she, once again, has her choice. She's going to go. I think that's a six. There. Sends that one home. She's calling that one in the corner. This ought to be an interesting shot. Oh, she's going with it. Oh, the 13 in the corner. I wonder if that five's in the way. It was. Oh, she's solids? You know I don't see that well, right? Matt easing in the 15, staring at, looks like the 14. He's calling the 13. Once again, the five ball. In the way, or is it? Oh, that was so close. Great idea. Didn't happen, but Tessa is going to send the orange orb into the side pocket, looks like. Yes. She's real close to the eight ball. If she's going corner pocket. Let's check our international connection here for just a moment. Look at that. She sent that one there. She's calling that in the corner pocket. And she, so close. Now Matt has an opportunity to rescue himself from impending eight ball doom. He's halfway there. Oh, and look, he has a perfect for that western side pocket. Perfect shot. It's back to that 13 that's been his nemesis the last few shots. Can he?
He has his earpiece in. No!
Wow, who'd have thunk it?
Thanks, Brian. What do you say?
Right, Matt making sure all the protocols are in place, making sure all the forms have been filled out before the eight ball shot. And Tessa is victorious, sending Matt to the consolation bracket where he will. Folks, it does look like we have a fantastic connection with César in Guatemala. You watch your language. What did he say? Oh.
All right. Todd and Ray Lee.
Todd and Ray Lee.
Hey, Todd, use that composite stick here. That composite stick will win itself.
Todd has a composite pool cue.
Is he there?
He is.
He's talking to somebody else.
With someone across the room. Yeah. Which is okay. We're ready anytime.
He's looking.
We could probably, maybe we could hone in on his audio. Eavesdrop. Let's eavesdrop on César.
Eavesdropping. You can hear us, buddy? You can hear us? Yeah, there we go. Hey, buddy.
Hey, guys. Yes.
Very good, man. Who you got there with you?
I'm good. Some friends.
There we go.
We just came from church, so we're just hanging out.
All right.
Yeah.
So, it's that time, man.
It is that time. Our international connection with cool. César Casasola.
All right, man. The awesome. Last time we tried to do this didn't work so well, so I'm glad you're on.
Yeah.
I'm going to do it now. You see Brian okay, right?
Yeah.
Perfect.
Right. Yeah. Cool.
Brian, right?
Yes, Brian.
Cool.
Good talking to you, César. Hey, listen, this is the part of our show where it's just a kind of a, we call it our international connection. And we kind of get to know the folks that we're speaking with. Obviously, you're in Guatemala. What is the weather like
in the
now
city.
In Guatemala? What city are you in?
In the Guatemala City.
Guatemala
the
city.
Actual city of the country.
The actual city of the country. Wow, that's like New York, New York, except completely different.
So
Guatemala.
You call your way of understanding.
Well, I have to make it relevant for our viewers. So Guatemala, Guatemala City. Tell us about that. How many people are in the city?
How many people?
Yeah.
Let's say almost half of the population lives in the city.
Almost half of the entire population of the country lives in Guatemala City. So it is kind of like New York.
It's not a big country.
Okay. Hey.
You have a lot of chatting there, so it's kind of hard to hear you.
I know. Sorry. It is exciting. And the reason is that we have a pool tournament going on, so we have to show this shot. Who did that, Ray Lee or Todd? Who was that? Todd sunk the eight ball on the break. It bumps off the three and scoots right to the side pocket. Folks, Texas Big Star eight ball showdown. The rules are if you sink the eight ball on the break, you're an automatic winner. Looky there. There it goes. Wow. Hey, César, do you guys have anything like that in Guatemala? They play pool there? They play pool.
Well, we do play pool. It's just that it has a bad connotation. It's kind of like if you play pool, it means that you're also doing some other bad things.
I see. Sure.
Yeah. But yeah, professionally speaking, people play it here. Yeah. Sure.
Right. Okay. Well, we were talking. You said over half the population of Guatemala, the country, live in Guatemala City. That's a lot of people.
Yeah, the thing is that it's a centralized country. Everything about law, everything about work, everything about international businesses comes to the city. Like, we just have two airports, really. And one of them is international. The city. And the other one, it's close to the Mayan ruins. Have you ever heard of the Tikal ruins?
Sure.
If you ever heard of Star Wars, which is, I know, very well known in the U.S., there was one episode that was recorded there.
Huh.
In Mayan City. Yeah. Not the whole episode, but...
one of the scenes in Star Wars. Cool.
I think it was episode 5. If I'm not...
Episode 5, they shot some stuff there. The my son in Tennessee, when we were in school there last year, one of his friends, Carlos, his parents were from Guatemala. Now, I don't know where. It wasn't in Guatemala City because it was out in the countryside up in the hills because his father bought a coffee plantation, a coffee place. And so he's growing... single origin, of course, Guatemalan coffee beans, which is an Arabica bean, That's very tasty. A little bright, a little bit of a tanginess to it, I believe, from what I remember of Guatemalan blend. And not a blend, but a single origin. And so is the weather different in Guatemala City than it would be where the coffee's grown?
Yes. Guatemala has a lot of hills. Yeah. It's a hill country.
Yes.
So I forgot about this way of explaining. There's a line of mountains that, you know, create the whole Central America area all the way to the Andes.
Yes.
Sierra Madre, to the Andes in the south, right, in South America. Because of that, Guatemala has a lot of hills. And you can drive half an hour, and the weather can change completely. So wow. When you talk about coffee, you can have different type of flavors in it just because of where it was grown. You can have coffee that was grown in the, let's say, the west side of the country, close to Mexico. And that side is very cold, very high. Yeah. The altitude. So the flavor, the taste of the coffee bean is going to be very different. From the west, from the east, I'm sorry, which is close to Honduras and Mexico. That's going to be more hot, more arid, and at the same time lower, closer to the sea level.
Huh.
So, yeah, you can have different type of taste in the coffee.
Hey, say sorry, can you do us a favor? You're on the screen. There's not a lot of light on your computer.
Oh,
can you position maybe a lamp, searchlight? Maybe just bring a car and turn the headlights on. Anything at this point, because right now it looks like you're underground broadcasting from a cave.
Yeah, I'm being persecuted right now. So
you're underground. Like a secret video from China.
Like
there we go. Hey, there he is. Wow.
From out of the shadows, I'm coming out.
Yeah, go ahead and turn the light off that's on the ceiling. Can you turn that one off? And then, but keep the lamp on. Yeah, and can you turn up the brightness on your laptop also? Gonna try that. I think that'll help too if you turn the brightness up.
Would that help?
That did. Yeah. There we go.
Right.
Awesome. Are you having to hold the light with one arm?
Yeah. It's my cell phone, really.
It's your cell phone. Yeah. Hey, get one of your friends to hold that for you so you don't, unless you really want to work out your deltoids. And...
That works.
We're getting there. Oh, we're moving to a different location. Like near a window? You're mobile.
There it is.
Oh,
oh
yeah.
Computer.
Now we're talking.
No?
Yeah, if you can get face the other direction so you're facing the window. There you go. Yeah. Nice. Okay. Cool. There you are. thanks for accommodating us, man. Cool. So, César, that's interesting about the coffee because I like coffee and I've tasted a lot of single origin beans from different places. Is there anything, what else in Guatemala? Like around here we have farms and lots of cattle. Is there a lot of livestock there in Guatemala?
Yes. Depending on the area, of course. I live in the city, so like you were saying, this is like New York. All you have here is cars all over the place, right? But if you go to where I was born, which is close to Honduras, the place is very arid, so I would say where I was born is almost like Texas. That's how I used to live in Texas. So when I was, like, I felt like a home.
Okay. Cool.
But I was born. A lot of cattle, a lot of big trucks, a lot of people with boots and hats. Yeah.
Boots and hats.
Yeah.
So it's not too different then. You said you were near Honduras. Does Guatemala grow tobacco?
Tobacco, Yeah, a little bit.
I know Honduras has some tobacco, obviously, for the cigar trade and things of that nature, but I was just curious. Well, César, we're here at Texas Big Star Live. We'd like to kind of like share our thoughts and our greetings with people in the international community, and that being you, of course. And one of the ways we do that is by we choose someone from the audience here at the Horny Toad Bar and Grill to communicate or send a greeting out to you, and some common phrases that would maybe we could use if we were in Guatemala, but in the native language that they would speak in Guatemala, whether good or bad. Sometimes people do a pretty good job. Sometimes it's very entertaining.
I see. And,
so I wrote out some phrases that someone's going to be speaking in just a moment. And assuming they just hopped off the plane and showed up, would you be able to understand them? So we're going to give that a try. What do you say?
Yeah, let's try it.
All right, let's try it. All right. Looks like they're motioning for Big Chris to be involved. And this ought to be good. We're going to have Big Chris speak to you in Spanish, some phrases that he may use if he's there in Guatemala.
Here just a warning, though. Spanish, it's a very, very varied language, I guess. You know, it has a lot of cultural background in it.
Right.
So if you say Spanish, maybe you think of Spain, but it's not the same Spain as in Argentina, sure. As in Mexico, right. As in Central America, South America. So sometimes when you're trying to say something really, really nice, you end up just really messing up.
Yeah, yeah. And that's what makes the show really fun to watch.
Yeah.
Here comes Big Chris.
So what I gotta do?
Hey, Big Chris, come on over.
I haven't even done my news yet.
Hey, César, this is Big Chris.
What's up, buddy? Nice to meet you.
Here's some headphones for you, man. Put them things on and we'll...
Do I gotta listen to them now?
Yeah. There we go. Yeah, this is... we call him Big Chris. He's 7 feet tall, César.
Oh, I see. I see why.
Is he too loud? Too loud? Good now?
All right. Okay, we're good to go.
Good to go. All right.
How's it going, buddy?
Doing good.
All right. Nice to meet you.
Nice
Chris,
to meet you, too.
What I have here are some phrases, and he's in Guatemala. It's a variation of Spanish, as César was explaining. So some of these may not translate, but that's the beauty of it. So this first question, what you're going to do is just read what's on there and to see if César can figure out what it is you were trying to say.
All right,
here's question, or I'll phrase...
Question number one.
Phrase number one.
Quinta Trill El... Magic Cafe de la Cuba.
Let's try it one more time.
Okay.
Let's try this in Spanish this time.
It's a try. ¿Quién tiene?
Carte Tinte.
El mejor.
El Mojo Cafe
de la
Ciudad. Cheetah.
Okay.
Yeah. Here we go. Let's try. Lil Chris.
They're sending in
reinforcements. Some of this is a little tricky, isn't it?
You have to tell me what he says, all right?
Okay, I will. Read number one.
Lil Chris is helping us out.
Okay.
What just happened?
Just read it.
Quintien el mejor café de la ciudad.
He laughed.
Dude, I need to come help you.
Are you saying take care of the coffee?
Close. Close. How about, ¿quién tiene el mejor café de la ciudad?
Ah, there you go.
Wow.
Who has the best coffee in the city?
The question, who has the best coffee in the city?
All right, now I get it.
And the answer is?
Well, I do.
You do. Cool.
Perfect. No, come on.
Number two.
Let's try the second phrase here.
Here you go, LC.
Go for it.
All right, I'm going to try it. This
is going to
be
difficult. E's.
All right.
E's racist.
Big Chris.
Hi, I'm trying to help you.
you two guys compliment each other.
I'm trying to say it.
Okay.
So, ¿es usted pescador?
Am I a fisherman?
Yes, correct. Are you a fisherman?
Are you a fisherman? Good job. Now we got the last one.
Well, hey, César, do you do any fishing there?
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah, we go for marlies in the Pacific.
You get to fish in the Pacific. That's nice. That's
we just
nice.
Got Lake Whitney.
We just got Lake Whitney.
That's all we got.
Okay, so last phrase. Here we go, César.
Okay, this one's a double liner, so I'm gonna. Okay.
Well, actually, just kind of go.
All right.
Yeah, here. There you go. Yeah, you're right. Two liner.
¿Tienes sombrero morado que puedo usar?
If I have a purple hat that you can use?
Yes!
Yes!
Exactly!
Yes!
Isn't that a common phrase in Guatemala? You look,
yes.
Yeah, you did a good job, LC.
I guess it is, huh?
No, I try and find interesting phrases that'll make you smile, too.
Yeah.
Wow, Lil Chris and Big Chris.
That'd be nice with a bread, sure.
That'd be great, thanks.
Yeah, guys.
Good job.
Yeah,
good
he
job.
Said good job.
Thank you.
Nice job. Well, César,
muy bien. Muy bueno.
He's giving you applause. That was fun. That was really, really fun.
You can come to Guatemala anytime now. You're ready.
You're ready to come to Guatemala now. Anytime.
Let's go.
Let's
go. We're going to Mexico. We're going to run out to Mexico.
Are you?
Let's go, Big Chris.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's a bit.
Mama don't know.
Oh, wow. César, one last question. If, so you lived, you said you lived in Texas?
Yeah.
So you're a Cowboys fan?
Oh, yeah. Go Cowboys.
Yeah.
Even though right now you just.
9-1.
Yep, they won today.
They won today, yeah.
So, well, didn't you just have a new quarterback now?
Mm-hmm. Dak Prescott.
That's right.
Yeah.
So they're moving along in the playoffs. How many teams are left?
We're not even in the playoffs yet. We're still in the regular season.
Really?
We got 6 more games.
They're only 9-1.
Oh, that's right. It's not like high school football.
So they might lose every 6 games, and we might not be in the playoffs.
Don't jinx them.
But
Chris, we're already in the wild card, no matter what. So we're basically in the
wild card. If we win, the next 2 games, then we'll be home field advantage.
Wonderful, César. Football is a big deal. Football's a big deal, especially high school football, which is what I've been keeping up with.
Meridian got beat 76-0.
That's our local team.
Nice.
Second playoff.
Cool.
Not quite yet. Not quite yet. We're still talking to César.
Okay.
Get off.
Oh, yeah, I got to do my Duke of Hazzard thing.
So, César, is soccer pretty prominent down in Guatemala?
Oh, yes. Yeah. Even though we just lost the classification for the World Cup.
Really?
But yeah, it is a big thing.
How did that happen?
Okay, you talk to him. I got to go finish eating.
We got to the final stage, which is the final 6. But then you had to, beat those final 6 in order to get 3 tickets for the World Cup. And right now, the only ones left are Mexico, The U.S., who else? I think Honduras. No, Panama. Panama and Costa Rica.
Okay. Wow.
Argentina is out too. Argentina is not going to the World Cup. That's sad.
Yeah. It is sad. It is very sad. I saw the match, and it was very close for a long time. So was the Guatemala match.
Yeah. So.
It was tough. Hmm.
You follow soccer?
I follow soccer, yes. My favorite player is Clint Dempsey from U.S., so. Mm-hmm.
Dempsey, yeah, he's a veteran already. He's good, man. Mm-hmm.
Great score, yeah. Great score.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I play guitar some.
I think I could have saw a video of you playing guitar, man. You're good.
Oh, well, thanks. I've been doing that a while. It's a stress reliever for me.
It is.
Right. Matt says you play.
Well, I attempt to play.
Oh. Hey, what was it like playing with Jake a long time ago?
Oh, it was awesome. Those guys are very talented too. Jake and his sister and the whole family. Yeah.
Jake just told me that you were the guitarist when the first time Jake ever sang in public.
Oh yeah, it was at a wedding.
Yeah.
I think if that's what he said. Yeah. He would do it in public also at the church.
Yeah, true. That's true.
But I guess it's a different kind of public in a wedding, right?
Right. Oh, cool. César, what about your? You have a cowboy friend. Who's your cowboy friend?
He was my boss. I'm not at my job anymore. I got laid off. Uh-huh. But he's a very good. He knows everything about being a cowboy. That's why I wanted to bring him on this show, so you guys get to know him too. But not today though. Yeah.
So maybe we
should
look up.
He knew every single detail about coffee.
Huh?
Yeah, I actually talked to him about being on today, but he wasn't available for this date.
I wonder, is there a difference in the look of a U.S. and Texas cowboy versus what a Guatemalan cowboy looks like?
I gotta go.
You gotta go?
Right. It's nice meeting you.
Nice to meet you, buddy.
Nice to meet you.
Lil Chris has gotta go play pool. I think he's undefeated.
Continue with your Spanish.
Thank you.
Lil Chris is gonna be playing his mother for, it's in one of the, it's in the playoff game. It's not quite the championship, but it's a pretty, pretty big game. So he's playing against his mom. So
all right.
You say the a Guatemalan cowboy looks just in the attire, the things they wear. Do they look the same as a Texas cowboy?
I would say so. I mean, everything about cowboys in a way they look up to what you guys do. So yeah, they pretty much copy what you guys wear. I don't know. We will have some of our local hat designers, but other than that,
local hat designers,
you will use caps, you will use the spears depending on what you're gonna do, right?
Right. I wonder if we can look up a picture of a Guatemalan cowboy, because for me, I've noticed there's a different look in different countries that have cowboys.
Okay.
And a lot of times you're right. It has to do with the hat, the way it's shaped, the size of the hat, and this. Sometimes a lot of them work with whips. That's
okay.
Different. Jake's going to look up a picture of a Guatemalan cowboy. Maybe he can AB our standard Texas cowboy, and then next to I'm making him work, aren't I? It's like, hey, listen, Jake, I believe in you. Well, that's interesting. Okay.
Now you will say the best cowboys are in the South.
I don't know. Can César, did you see that picture? Oh, you can't see it. Okay. No, no. Sorry about that. I wish you could. Well, it looked interesting. A little bit different than the standard Texas cowboy. The hat was kind of similar.
Send the link.
Send the link. César, when was the last time you were in the United States?
I left there in 2014.
Oh, just a couple years ago then.
Yep.
Yeah. Okay. Cool.
Oh, okay. I got the link.
Oh, you got the link. Is it?
Let me see.
What do you think about that picture?
Yeah.
That's it's now tell me.
That's a very thing mix.
That's an amazing. Is that normal?
This is normal for native Guatemalans.
It is for native Guatemalan.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's not really a cowboy. It's more like a person that lives in the countryside. Kind of
right. Way. Right. Right. Okay. That's the image. Yeah. That's what came to mind when I saw it too.
This is more like what do you call it? Our ethnicity. It represents our ethnicity.
Sure.
Rather than an actual cowboy. Yeah.
Right.
This is like Mayan, probably. We're descendants from Mayans, and the country is about 70 to 75% of that descent. I'm the other percent.
Gotcha. Yeah.
So when you see this picture, you're looking at a person that might be dialect, that lives in the mountain, probably
mountain people,
and maybe knows a little bit of Spanish, but not much.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Is there a name for the mountain people, the folks that live in the mountains?
It's not really tribal. It's just that they still live that way.
Right.
Yeah. But they're kind of connected to the country.
I was in Peru years ago, and there was, I forget the name that they had for the folks that were in the mountainous areas that they were known as. And there was thousands of them, but... way up.
Yeah, all of us. In Peru, they have the Tarahumaras, I think. Mm-hmm. No, that's Chile. Chile has the Tarahumaras. But yeah, a lot of ethnicity in all Latin America. In Guatemala, what we have is the Mayans, pretty much.
Sure, sure.
Yeah. And from that, you have at least about 20 to 25 different ethnicities to ride. You have Quiches, you have Cachiqueles, Pocomchis, Mam, Pocomam, Tutuil, and it goes on. Yeah. And it's kind of like saying, if you're thinking in Central America, kind of like saying Guatemala, El Salvador, Honduras, Nicaragua, Costa Rica, Panama, kind of like that. They are different, but they have a lot of comedy.
There's a unity also, yeah.
Yeah.
That makes sense. So, that makes sense.
It's kind of like saying Texans. You can have people that live in Texas, but you cannot say the San Antonians are the same as the people from Houston, as the Dallas. You know, they all represent different, I don't know, history. In San Antonio, you have the Alamo. In Houston, you have the NASA.
NASA. Sure. Each area has its own specific history and what makes it what it is. Around here, in fact, there's been a lot of Texas maps drawn along where to find the best tacos. That's how they separated certain regions were known as. That's a great taco region. Here, you don't want to go so much, but over, you know, different places. A lot of it's based on food too. César, do you speak any other dialects?
I don't speak any other dialects, but I know phrases. That's what I know.
Phrases?
Yeah.
What are some phrases?
From
the area that you live in here.
When something is over, when you're finishing an activity, a job, whatever it is, a relationship, maybe a breakup.
Uh-huh.
It's a ishkamik.
One more time slowly. I may need to know this phrase.
You say ishkamik.
Ishkamish?
Ishkamik with a K at the end.
Kamik.
Ishkamik.
Ishkamik. Mm-hmm. Meaning
there you go.
It's Finnish. Ishkamik.
It's Finnish. Well, it literally means it's dead.
It's dead.
But what it means, it's finished, yeah.
Well, the pool game that I'm watching is about to be Ishkamik because...
There you go.
Oh, Tessa is playing her son, Lil Chris, and she just missed the A-ball shot, so he is going for a bank shot in the corner pocket. It might be Ishkamik, and it is not. Oh, but it is about to be now because Tessa is going to respond. Ooh, goodness me. She's looking at, she's about to end this game, I believe. It is about to be Ishkamik. She's going for the opposite corner. Is interesting. That was very close. Oh, and is it going to go in the side pocket? Oh, it did. Oh, she just lost. Ishkamik. Oh, wow.
There you go.
So it means it is finished. It's over. Okay. Any other phrases you have, César?
Let me think. I can't remember right now.
Anything to do with food?
I think in order to be silent, if I'm right, like if you want everybody to listen to you and
yeah.
You know, you want to get their attention, you have to say makashipek.
Makashipek?
Makashipek.
Makashipek.
And that means silent, please. I'm about to say something.
Makashipek.
Makashipek.
Makashipek. I could try that here to get everybody's attention, but
and that's some kind of just for you to know, some kind of Mayan dialect.
Some Mayan dialect. Cool. Makashipek. All right. I'm liking this. Learning and learning. Hey, Matt's back.
I'm saying hi and thank you, buddy. It's been a while.
Yeah, man. No problem.
Yeah.
It's been fun.
You always have a nice smile.
He does.
I was concerned if we were going to be able to hook up with you today. Man. This week has been so crazy. We weren't able to do the test that we normally do, so it was all today. So, thank you very much. We appreciate it. The Wallace family, a big César fans. We miss you. Jake just yelled that. You got your own microphone in your own.
César, echamos de menos mucho.
Yeah,
awesome. There's a lot of noise in the background, so it's kind of hard to hear. But yeah.
She's saying nice things to you.
She is.
So thanks, buddy. Appreciate it.
So Jake, next time he has to come here to, he gets Spanish.
Yeah, Jake wants to come. I mean, Morgan was talking about coming down and doing some conference there. So you never know.
Oh, cool.
Hope that works out.
All right.
So you always have a place here, man. You know that. Come see it sometime. We'll have you back on sometime in the future. You get your buddy, cowboy friend.
Yeah. You're going to have a lot of more fun with him because I just moved to Guatemala 2 years ago. I'm catching up with my own background, culture background.
All right, buddy. Thank you. Take care.
Right.
Bye.
Thanks, César.
Nice to meet you guys.
Thanks.
Nice to meet you. We'll see you.
Bye-bye.
So, there you go. César Casasola.
César Casasola.
Go ahead and end it, buddy. What is it when you kill it? It is dead?
I forget now. Hey, how do you say it is dead again, César?
Ishkamik.
Ishkamek.
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 There you go.
Cool. Thanks, man.
So, Tessa and Penny are playing to see who's going to play Lil Chris in the finals.
You think Tessa just threw that game?
Definitely looks that way.
It was a legit shot.
She almost made it.
She almost made it, and that would have been cool.
Well, yeah, to be fair, the way it was lined up on the actual rail, she'd have to hit it just perfectly or it would have popped out and not made it.
Yeah.
And if she had hit it just right, the cue ball could have followed it in.
Right.
I don't know. I mean, it definitely looks like she threw it, but after looking at it closely, I don't know. You're not going to tell Tessa what to do.
She's apt to do that. You know, she shoots one-handed sometimes.
Yeah, Tessa's going to do what Tessa's going to do. She's playing and I'm not, so what am I going to say?
That is true.
So we're going to have to get you to play sometime.
Yeah, I need to.
Very chill here right now.
Yeah, it's pretty relaxed. You know, César.
What's Dylan saying? Dylan looked like he was talking to the microphone with a big grin on his face. What's so funny? Is he's playing a game on his phone or something? What are you doing, Dylan?
He's doing words with friends, or he's chatting with someone else. Are you twitching? Is he twitching right now? Can you twitch during another broadcast? Doesn't that create some sort of digital mirror image and an endless loop?
Dylan's famous on Twitch. What's the name? Sloth Time Lord? Sloth Time Lord. If you go to twitch.tv or .com. He's going to pull it up.
Yeah, here we go.
We're going to plug Dylan's page as if anybody who watches this show is going to go to Twitch. But you never know.
Hey, I watch the show and I go to Twitch.
That's true.
There could be at least 10% of our audience.
There you go. Twitch.tv/
Sloth Time Lord.
Sloth Time Lord. But he plays, you can log on there and make requests and he'll play it for you. He did like 3 hours yesterday, if I understood it correctly. Non-stop music. Dylan's big smile on his face went away. Oh, what happened? What happened? What happened? It's an ad.
Oh,
you can't go to that.
I thought that was his music video. I was about to say, yeah, it was well done. Professional shoot.
You know, I have this ability. Dylan had this big smile on his face, and now that I engaged, he's not smiling anymore.
No. I can't see. No, there he is. He's still smiling.
Oh, okay. Can you pipe him into the audio feed? What do you want to say, Dylan? You got to talk to us now. I don't know. Dylan doesn't want to be in the audio, but we're going to put him in anyhow.
Put me in the audio.
Come on, you have to talk to us now, Dylan.
What's up, Dylan?
Dylan! Talk to us,
y'all,
man.
Y'all can't see me.
We can't see you. Tell us about your channel. Come on, Dylan.
Am I still in? I play music on the internet sometimes. You watch me.
Tell them about the banana.
Yeah, when we reach a certain amount of followers, which is usually every like 500 or so, I'll put a banana suit on and play songs in a banana suit.
So right now he's at 1721,
yeah,
and
we're
he needs
a little over 250
when he hits
away.
When he hits 2,000, he plays the whole gig in a banana suit.
Yep.
I mean, that's what the internet's about, guys.
Exactly.
Nice haircut, Dylan. I like that.
Setting goals to be in a banana suit.
Setting goals to be in a banana suit. Yeah, we love watching Dylan play. Listen to him too. Yeah. Dylan did a music video based on Stranger Things. There he is. Gray Sky Symphony. That's Dylan. And he did a music video. So what?
I have many names on the internet.
He does.
For various purposes.
Have you ever watched Stranger Things? There's a character named Will.
There's Jake.
So Dylan, is that music going out? The music going out? That's original. Dylan's like, I don't know if I want us to be associated here or not. Did you see that? Jake was doing the hipster drummer head bob thing.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
It's a very bob and weave kind of thing.
Let's go on the Jake's YouTube channel.
Yeah, I don't think we're going to do that since Jake is in charge of the switcher. What are we looking at?
Pool.
They're playing. I guess we should pay attention. All right, the ladies are trying to knock
Penny,
each other out.
Only Lex. One, two. Yeah, so it's a, Penny has a little bit of catch up.
A little pucker factor going on.
That could have been rough. Tessa looked like she's simply going for the corner. Yep. And she
got one apiece.
Lax. One.
So Lil Chris is excited about possibly winning some root beer.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I wonder if Tessa happens to beat Penny, if Chris has enough pull to talk Tessa into getting the root beer, even if he doesn't win.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Chris is over there chowing down on dinner.
He's eating wings.
What are you eating? Wings?
Yeah. Horny Toad's got good wings. Well, Tessa right down the line to the southwest corner pocket. And yes, she sends it home.
Uh-oh.
Eight ball.
Looks like...
Now, this particular shot can sometimes be dangerous. Momentum can carry that cue ball straight into the pocket that you want the eight ball to go in.
So just a little left.
But
like
she
that.
Seals
there you go.
The deal, defeating Penny. Tessa moving again up to the championship game, which is going to be Tessa and little Chris. Mom playing against son in the championship game. My, my, my. Come on over, y'all.
Come here. Come on, kid.
Well,
there might
he's
be.
He's gonna go for her because, yeah.
This is a first, right?
Well, every time we play each other in a tournament, we usually have to play.
Every time we enter a tournament and we're in the same tournament, uh-huh. We play each other.
But this would be the first time for the final.
Yeah, this is a championship game. What do you think?
Who do you think's gonna win?
Scooter.
Oh, it hasn't run down yet.
No. The final.
Me and Mom.
It's a championship game.
And Chris. Who are you going to pick?
I've got to put my money on Mom.
Oh, we knew that.
See, it doesn't even matter because she don't even like sodas. So if she wins and gets the sodas, she's not even going to drink them anyways.
Wow. So you might win either way for you.
I think in order to make this, you know, work for me, we better add some, like,
no.
Side bets,
no.
Like laundry.
No. You know I don't do that. You know I don't do that. Mom, I don't do that. I don't do that, everybody.
Some toilet cleaning over the Thanksgiving break. Yeah.
Dishes
are good.
Because then she'll actually, like, beat me, like,
then I'll
really badly.
Try. Well, we better make it something.
No.
That...
Especially over Thanksgiving and holiday.
I'm good with a case of root beer.
I got a great idea. Oh. Just pick up after itself.
Oh.
Scott, this is not the
generally
place.
Cleaning up.
This is not the place
that's
to
gotta
zing.
Hurt.
Not the place to zing.
You drug me up here.
They asked for it, not me.
I said we go with laundry. Laundry?
No.
Laundry.
No. How many loads?
Okay, so we have decided
four.
On laundry.
No.
Three loads.
No.
Three loads of
no.
laundry.
Three loads.
A case of root beer.
No, I'm good with playing. No, I'm good with just playing. What do I get if I...
Look, did anybody see when he came up here? The feathers sticking out? There's feathers.
I don't
you see
care.
Them? They got to be growing now.
I don't care.
Things are getting,
I don't
it's
care.
Getting rough now. This is intense.
Okay,
all right.
Quarter.
Who has the coin?
Quarter.
Let's toss and see who's going to be doing what. Here, I'll tell you what I'll toss.
Who gets the
you
call?
Make the
I'm
call. That means she gets to make the call. Ready?
Heads.
On, Tessa calls heads.
Yes.
Heads it is.
Hey, ball on the break. Going for it?
Yeah, what are you like?
This is going to be a good game.
This is going to be a good game. Tessa has to beat her son, Chris, twice in order to become a champion of this particular installment, Texas Big Star Live 8 Ball Showdown, Episode 10. Has to beat him twice. Folks, thank you and for being part of today's show. You're watching Texas Big Star Live, and this is the maybe the first and only, but maybe the first of two championship games right here of our Texas Big Star Live 8-Ball Showdown. Tessa playing her son, Chris.
That's what happened with
woo-hoo. He has racked them. Tessa will crack them. Boom. Boom and boom. She did drop a solid. But cue ball is pinned in back over there in the northwest corner. Looks like she does have a clear shot to the five. And didn't make it. I think she was going for a combo. But it did not make it. It's been an easy-going afternoon here at the Horny Toad Bar and Grill in Cranfills Gap. Texas. Chris looks like he's calling a combo, a B&H, a Bang and Hope combo in that general direction. That does successfully drop the 11. But that is not the combo that he called, apparently. So he does get credit for the ball, but he does lose his turn, leaving Tessa a wide open shot for that lingering 7. But a recurring scratch will send the ball back to Chris's way. Yes. Yes. Hey, let's get Sandi. Sandi of the Horny Toad. Here she comes. I hear she has something she wanted to talk about.
Brian, at some point you have to sing that song for her.
How are you?
I'm great. How are you?
Doing well. Welcome.
Good.
Here's
good.
Your microphone.
All right. Thank you.
Is it cold out there?
It's cold in the building.
It's cold okay. in the building.
All right. So I'm supposed to invite people to come to Austin to see us? Is that what? All right.
Yes.
What we're going to do is come Thursday, we start our annual distributions. Okay. And we're going to be meeting...
Distributions for, just to remind everyone.
Okay. It's an organization called Nikki Warms the Cold, in memory of Nikki. And we give coats and blankets and hats and toboggans and snack foods and water and
toiletries to those less fortunate. And it started, I guess this will be our, hard to believe, but I think it's our seventh.
Seventh
our
year.
Our seventh year to distribute.
Damn, that's very hard to believe.
So anyway, we meet down on, I can't remember if it's 6th and Red River or 7th and Red River, about 10 o'clock. We set up, and it takes us about an hour and a half to 2 hours, and we lower our, I mean, you got to see it to understand it. I mean, we'll have to do pictures, and we'll get them up. But this, we always do Thanksgiving, or we try to do Thanksgiving first, and then from here in December, we're going to San Antonio. And we're going to do something a little different in San Antonio that we've never done before. And then from there, throughout the year, we'll hit Waco and Fort Worth and maybe Dallas. And we've done Killeen and we've done Temple. So those, it just depends on who we can work with throughout the winter. And anyway, that's what we're going to do.
That is it's wonderful.
Thursday, 10 o'clock.
Is there a website that folks can go to?
You know what? I will post it on the Toad. I'll post it on the Toad page because somebody else asked me that. I don't have a website for Nikki Warms the Cold. We do have a Facebook page, and it's Nikki Warms the Cold, Hope for Brighter Tomorrows. And I'll try and get that out there, but I'll also share it on the Toad page because somebody was asking me about that yesterday. So I'll share it on the Toad page as well.
Nikki Warms the Cold, Hope for Brighter Tomorrows.
Nikki Warms the Cold. You know, and I'm going to share that. She, I was with her the day before we lost her. She said, Mom, tomorrow we're going to get tattoos. And I'm going to put a cross right here, and I'm going to hope for brighter tomorrows. So we feel like whether we're distributing or when we do our crawfish boil and or whether we have bacon bash for juvenile diabetes, all these things, whatever we do, we are giving someone a hope for a brighter tomorrow. Okay?
Yes.
All right. All right. Thank you. Come see us. It'll be great.
Thank you. Wow, back to Texas Big Star Live 8 Ball Showdown. A lot has transpired in just a few minutes. Chris, playing catch up to his mom, and scratches, leaving her an interesting situation. She has playing catch up herself. This championship game could be over with one shot in less than 60 seconds. Little Chris has the opportunity to win because his mom has already been beaten once. He's going with a bank shot, you said?
Game shot.
Oh, game shot, yes. Straight on. Straight on. Here goes Chris. And he scratches. Oh, goodness. Which means that they are all tied up. And this championship is going one more game. Matt comes in with the draw. This is, wow. You can, you know, the excitement is palpable in the room. Big Chris is just feeling the air of excitement himself, I'm pretty sure. No, I'm sorry, he's on Facebook. He's on his phone at the bar. Something else is exciting him. But that couple over there is, they're watching. In spirit, they're with us. I think Tessa's not gonna. She's not. She's going. She's going for the kill here.
Mothers tend to do that sometimes. They're not gonna let it slide. Have you ever seen Matt's mom play games with him?
Ruthless.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Hey, absolutely. On, 1 second.
Todd, why don't you go commentate with Ryan?
Hey. Todd's gonna come up and help me commentate.
Yeah.
This is about to get interesting. I can feel it.
Okay, I can tell you how this. No, I'm not putting no tape on my mouth. No. No, that's not. I got my No Shave November going on.
No Shave November.
Yeah.
Awesome.
I can't talk the tape on my mouth.
I know that's.
What we got here is we got mom playing a kid, playing her son, and she's going to let the son win.
So.
Well, I'm saying, my money, I tried to bet her $10 that her son's going to win, she wouldn't bet me.
I see.
So we'll see.
The reason I didn't win today. I'm giving everybody else a
chance. That's right. Ray Lee said he won last week, so he's just going to back off.
Ray Lee threw every game he was in.
I made the eight ball on the break. I could do that every time, but I can't do, you know, wouldn't be much competition. What?
Stop lying to yourself and everybody you're talking to.
Little Chris chiming in, saying that he loves Todd so much.
Everybody in the world.
But look at the fun we have.
No, we have a great time. Looking, all right, here's 15 ball inside, and he makes it.
He does.
Little Chris is a pretty good shooter. I told him everything he knows. I've been shooting pool against him for a long time.
Smack talking.
Huh?
About smack talking.
Smack talking. Yeah, well, smack talking comes in handy.
Run from bang. Scratch.
Talk me how to do that.
I know. Whatever.
About talking smack.
Okay, well, whatever.
So, Todd, in your estimation, Miriam and I were just saying that we think she's taking off the gloves on this one. But you're saying the opposite. You're saying that she's going to
I don't know if she's going to throw the game or not, because this is a championship game. She may not, because they got laundry and toilet cleaning riding on
it. We don't have any bets.
Because Chris, yes, you do.
Oh, yeah. Well, Chris is still denying
the whole world saw y'all talking about it.
We didn't bet. I told her I didn't do it. I wasn't going to do it. I ain't bet.
That's because he took after the other stuff you learned from me on group feathers.
Group feathers, okay, whatever. Well, he's a smart boy, is all I can say. He's a good boy.
So but, what's the thing with Tessa and her love for ostriches? I don't get it.
No, it's not ostriches. Chicken. She keeps saying that when you chicken out, she says you go feathers.
Right. No, I knew that.
Well, okay, I didn't know you either or not.
And
I've taught Tessa everything she knows about cows, too. So, I mean, you know, it's just, I'm kind of taking these people under my wing to kind of help them out.
Your chicken wing?
I'm taking you under my chicken wing to help you out. That's what I've done.
For that, you should have to buy everybody who's watching a pair of boots.
A pair of boots?
Yeah, my
no.
boots.
No, really?
Shoes, Mom.
Tessa commenting on footwear.
Yeah.
Hold saying. Up. Let me get my feet on the ground.
Okay,
the
really?
Really?
You're sitting there. Oh, my God. Lord. All right, now combination.
I think she's going for the two in the corner directly. And
does good. Oh, you sit better on this TV thing.
Yeah,
I
can.
See. Who run the camera?
They're all right. Yeah,
you're doing a hell of a job, boy. I tell you, I like it.
Looks like she's going for the five ball in the corner and does not make it.
She did that on purpose.
Oh.
Maybe you need glasses. Maybe Tessa needs glasses.
Well, right now it's relatively even. Tessa, she's
the eight ball is in a precarious position. Like
it is.
Word laid on you.
Now it's.
I don't know what it means. But
she.
It's like in
she
a
has a lot more catch up to do.
Oh yeah.
Than Chris.
Well, Chris
does.
Is a good. I'm telling you, he's a good shooter. He's in a real good mood today.
Is it because it's Thanksgiving break?
I don't know. Maybe Thanksgiving break. Maybe they had a lot of sugar. I don't know. Something. He is like.
Nope.
Oh!
My!
He just
cleared
it up right there.
We have to replay that.
He will be doing,
not only was
he will
it a
be
scratch,
doing laundry cleaning
it
toilets
was
for the week of Thanksgiving.
Sinking the eight ball prematurely.
Okay.
And,
come here, Chris, and tell us what happened on that last shot.
Now I'm good.
You're good? He's good?
And Tessa is
Tessa
the
is
champion of Texas Big Star Live 8 Ball Showdown episode 10.
What happened there?
It's my second time.
Okay, girl. Really? I won it one time, you know. And I made the 8 Ball on break today.
We're going to watch.
It wasn't in your dreams.
We're going to watch the replay.
No, yeah.
You ready to watch the replay?
Let's replay. Watch
look at this.
Here we go.
It was a valiant effort. Man. Scratch. And then the corresponding knocking the 8 ball in.
They had a replay on my. They were not going to call in on
couldn't have seen that coming. Couldn't have seen that coming.
What? No, it's coming. What?
Huh? We couldn't have seen that shot coming. I mean, I would. I wouldn't have known that the A ball was. Right. It was there, but.
Everything wrong. She didn't let me win. I didn't win.
Okay. The key of it is, if you can't win, a man told me. Okay. The man told me one time, if you can't win, don't lose. And you lost.
My man also told me to get my feet off the ground.
All right, well, I just got a little more work to do with you, you know, to get you over the hump.
Composite stick.
That's a good stick.
Maybe I left some good juice on it for you to maybe. Find
me maybe. Here you go, Tessa. All right, tell them about how much laundry and toilet.
Laundry. Tessa, the victorious champion, Texas Big Star Live 8-Ball Showdown.
Yay. This is my second time.
Yeah, put that back up. We got to get two. There we go. All right, cool.
Yay. Very exciting.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Rayleigh.
Thank you, Rayleigh.
Thanks for dropping in. Hey, don't forget your Dublins. You got them? Wonderful.
Thank you, Toddy boy.
Yeah, anyway, I enjoy everything.
We do, too.
We'll see y'all. Next Sunday?
Next Sunday, yes.
I'm happy to thank you.
You too, sir.
Bye, Rayleigh.
See ya.
Exciting.
So, Miriam and I, we were before the game, we thought Tessa's not going to hold anything back. She's taking off the gloves and she's not going to throw the game.
Oh, playing against my kid?
Yeah.
Oh.
Todd thought just the opposite.
Yeah.
We were both wrong because we never got a chance to find out, actually, whether either one was right or wrong, because the game, it nulled itself, basically.
Yes.
There's, a win is a win. A W is a W.
Little Chris is pretty good, though.
He's a good shooter.
It's kind of been rough for me that he's gotten.
Did you take it easy on him the first game, though?
The first game in the tournament?
Uh-huh.
I don't know what you're talking about.
That was a valid. It was a valid shot.
No.
I'm looking for a guitar pick. What'd you do? Where'd it go? Has anybody here seen my guitar pick? Can you tell me where it's gone? It's sort of triangular, and it's gray and kind of flimsy. I just looked around and it was gone. That's all right. If I put the mic right here. There we go. How's that? It's a folk music ending for episode 10, everybody. Texas Big Star Live, coming in for a landing. Texas Big Star Live, coming in for a landing. It's our final approach. Final approach. Thank you, everybody, for tuning in to episode 10. Thank you all for watching, spending your time with us. Oh. Producers in my left ear saying everyone's going to sleep. Guess I'll pick it up for my own well-being. What do you think? Okay, let's do it. Let's do it. Do what he say! Do what he say! Welcome back, just for the last moments of the show where I make up something right here at the end. We do appreciate you watching Texas Big Star Live right here at the fabulous Horny Toad Bar and Grill in Cranfills Gap, Texas.